Greetings, YouTube. Today we're looking at the Gerber Paraframe 2 Clip Folding Knife, stainless steel handle and blade, 3.4 inches. Little blurb on the back, which will I will tell you what it looks like here. Here you go, is the Paraframe with its very unique, fully skeletonized handle. And I got this for $10. It was normally $20 or $19.88. I think I picked this up at Home Depot. That's one of the reasons I bought it, because it was on sale. So here we go. Now, I don't normally buy blades that have serrations, but again, for $10, I'd never seen one of these in person, so I wanted to give it a shot. And it's got, this is the flat, nice swedge, hollow grind, secondary bevels, and the serrations on this are quite nice. They got a nice tooth to them, and the blade comes out of the box reasonably sharp. We have thumb studs, frame lock, tip down carry, which is not my preference. I prefer tip up. I will say, however, that it's a very comfortable blade, full four-finger grip. I find it very comfortable to use. It's very simple. There's no jimping or anything on this thing. And I guess if you really wanted to do a reverse grip, you could. Not my thing. It is comfortable. This is too aggressive. Not the design. It's nice and smooth. Because of this cutout, you can easily access it. But the amount of force required to disengage this liner lock is excessive. I find it very uncomfortable. Also, this is very tight. I've loosened this on both sides. I cannot get this to be any looser. It just will not. I can open it, but it's actually easiest for me to open it. And if I hook my finger here, I do that so I can pull against my own hand to get leverage. I don't know if this is a characteristic of all Paraframe 2s or this is just this knife's quirks. I don't know. And I also don't know the difference between the Paraframe 1 and the Paraframe 2. If someone could point that out to me, that would be cool. But a nice little blade, well actually a nice decent sized blade, and I would characterize this as a medium duty knife. This could be a primary knife for many people, particularly if you like a decent sized blade that isn't huge, 3.4 inches. It's at the upper end for me, 3.5 is my max usually. The 3.5 injection I carry almost every day is about as big as I like. But this thing is also a little heavier because it's all steel. One of the downsides to this skeletonized handle, however, is that I can actually touch that edge right there. I can touch that with my hand. That makes me a little nervous. I'm not saying it's going to be a problem on a regular basis. It still makes me nervous. I would be happier if that wasn't possible. But that's just me. Maybe I'm being overly cautious. But if you like Gerbers, this is a solid buy, and I hope that your particular model you buy has a more friendly liner lock.